1980s ushered in a new era on Long Island, taunting the Midtown Rangers and flaunting a core of talent and toughness. Brian Trottier, Mike Bossy, Dennis Potvin, and Billy Smith led a team on the verge of history.
We were a young team. We loved our roles. We embraced everybody that came on the team and what they brought to the game. There were times, I'm sure, we frustrated coaches and management, but as a group, I think we wanted to win. And I think that was our greatest asset.
Now it comes close to Pinelli.
The Islanders reached their first Cup final in 1980 against the heavily favored Philadelphia Flyers. Their contrasting styles were evident, but the kids from Long Island refused to be intimidated and captured their first Stanley Cup.
Now I'm trying to get it to Bossy, broken up by Daly, and now Kelly comes up with it, but play called and a penalty coming up against Philadelphia.
I can give you one statement that won us that series against the Flyers. Whenever they took a penalty, we scored.
Mike Bossy trying to center one, Pierce, and scores!
And that was the key to that series. We scored 15 power play goals in six games.
Swing at center ice at the Flyer line, cut off and taken down by Lintzman, as we're going to have a penalty against the Flyers. Coming in, Pearson, screenshot, goal! And the Islanders now set a new all-time Stanley Cup playoff record for power play goals in the series.
End of story.
Despite the power play goals, the series came down to one perfect moment in overtime of Game 6.
We must have done 30,000 two-on-twos in practice, right? It never really were successful. That was the Stanley Cup, but it was something that we had rehearsed over and over again, and this just worked out just perfect. We never took our foot off the pedal. We won four in a row. I think it blew away the people who had thought that we might not be able to compete with a young team like that.
I just can't express just how happy you really feel that seeing that silver thing is back in this dressing room.
Playing for their fourth straight Stanley Cup, the Islanders faced a young team from Edmonton in the 1983 Cup final.
Oh my God.
We had a good team. Were we good enough to beat the Islanders? Definitely not. They had guys that just weren't going to give it up. Bossy, Gillies, Trottier, Plotso. And if you were going to win the Stanley Cup that year, you were going to have to earn it.
You know, I've been asked about the most important cup, and they're all important. The fourth one was particularly important because my dad had cancer, and we knew that there wasn't a lot of time left. And I knew that way up in the suite was my older brother Bob and my dad. I grabbed the cup and I lifted up to him, and Dad passed away the following year. But that was a moment that I'll never forget. It was very special.
After beating the Oilers, the Islanders joined an exclusive club. It was only the third time in NHL history a team had won four Stanley Cups in a row.
Oh, winning 19 series in a row, when you think about it, it's ridiculous, actually. To go almost 5 years without losing a playoff series, it'll never be done again.
We were fortunate. We had the talent, and we stuck together. We knew each other. Like a lot of people don't realize, there was 16 of us that won all four Cups. It's tougher today because you can't keep your team together. You can't let guys really get the bond that we had.
For the Oilers, the experience of another heartbreaking loss offered little consolation.
He took it as hard, if not harder, than anybody. And I remember saying that, it's okay, we'll be back next year, we'll be all right. He goes, no, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. He said, I'll never be as good. I still remember. He says, I'll never be as good as Brian Trottier and Guy Lafleur unless I win a championship.
In New York, the locker rooms are such that you got to walk past their locker room to get to the bus. It was really kind of surreal.
We ended up walking by the dressing room. We're kind of in our suits and we're walking out with a bunch of 20-year-old kids feeling good. And we kind of looked in their dressing room and they were all there in the training room. And ice bags here, ice bags here, ice bags on their knees and ankles. And we're thinking, wow, maybe we're not doing enough.
They're so physically and mentally beat that we realized right there and then that there's a difference between getting to the Stanley Cup and winning the Stanley Cup.